What's up? It's me, Eccentric Gamer, and it's time for more Pokemon Red. Finally. I feel like it's been ages, even though it's only been a couple of weeks, but still, it's like ages in video game, let's playing land, whatever thing. So anyway, I just want to show you guys before we start this off. I have also a few other things I need to say, but first I'm going to say, check it out! I leveled up all my Pokemans, and they all pretty good. So they should be fine through Victory Road. I'll probably train after I get through Victory Road and I get to the Pokemon League. I'll probably do that sort of thing, because I don't know if they'll level up enough in Victory Road, battling all the trainers that are in there, you know, in order to be ready for the Elite Four and stuff. I don't know if they'll be able to take them on with how much levels they're going to gain in the Victory Road, because they're still not leveled up enough to take on the Elite Four as of yet. So we'll have to see. I mean, you won't see that training either, just like you didn't see this training, which is why you're just like right now, oh man, it's so cool training. You train. Yeah, but anyway, a few things I want to announce, and I have a list of notes here that I wanted to talk about before I start this part up that I put on my iPod. Yeah, my iPad. No, iPod. My notes section. It's the note app that comes with it, so it's pretty cool. Okay, let's see. Let's just Ultra Ball next to grass. Oh yeah, while I was training in this grass, I accidentally walked down a bit, and then I pressed A for whatever reason. I don't know, I just have a habit of that. Which is why I kept reading those signs over there, which I'll show you after this. There's like an Ultra Ball right over around here. If you just look, go in here and press A somewhere, you'll find an Ultra Ball. But what I did was I kept accidentally, like, hitting this. I don't know why that's there. Indigo Plateau, the highest Pokemon authority, Pokemon League HQ. I don't know why that's there as a sign. It's like, why would you just go all the way? There's another one on the opposite side. Like, there's another pillar over there. Like that one. And I got into a wild battle. Oh well. Oh, look at that. Ditto. That's great. Yeah, you can find Dittos here. That's another note I'll talk about. I might as well talk about it now, actually. Actually, no. And I want to do it in order, because I'm weird like that. I'm just kidding. Mermaidia, try and learn Mist level 40. Yeah, Mermaidia was going to learn Mist, but I was like, screw that, because all it does is like make it so that stat changes don't happen and stuff, or something like that. Something to do with stat changes. Didn't care, because I don't want that. Skylar, Flamethrower level 46, Togekiss Ember. Oh, yeah, right. Scout learned Flamethrower, level 46, and I took out Ember, because it's basically Flamethrower, but not as good. Just saying. Talk about what wild Pokemon can be found in Victory Road and the grass outside it. Yeah, I was training in Victory Road and that area outside of it that I'm in right now. And as you saw earlier, you can find Dittos here, you can also find Firos, and also their pre-evolution Spearows. So lots of Sirbirds for everyone. You can also find Ekans and Arbok. There you go. That's all I've been able to find, at least, through all my training. And in Victory Road, you can actually find Marowak. So if you didn't get a Cubone in Pokemon Tower in Lavender Town, you can get that now. And no, it's not the same Marowak that Team Rocket killed. Different ones. I killed them all now. So does that mean I'm as bad as Team Rocket? Maybe. I'm not going to dwell on it, because whatever. And you can also find Gravelers in there, and Machokes, and also Machamps, but not Geodudes for some reason. No, I know, you can find Geodudes too. Sorry, forgot about that. And also, you can find Onix. So that's it for that, I think, yeah. And I mentioned that it is part 69 Giggity. Oh yeah! Hey, guess what part it is? It's number 69! Man, I can't believe it's already been that many parts. Jeez. How time doesn't fly, because I'm still playing the game. So yeah, those of you on the internet know that number 69 has a very special meaning, and if you don't know what that meaning is, then you probably just don't look it up, because you're probably too young. Just saying. Unless you're in like high school and you still don't know for some weird reason, then you can go ahead and look it up, because you probably know. Unless you're in some like extreme Catholic or extreme religion that your parents just don't like you looking up anything that's like inappropriate. In which case, I would not suggest doing that, but, you know, I know what it is, and probably a lot of people know what it is, so anyway, that's not the point. Point is, also, another thing I didn't write down, but I got a lot of items. I got 30 Hyper Potions, 15 Revives, 15 Full Heals, 25 Max Repels. I got 5 more than I did, like, before. I took out some items, like the rod I got, and some other things, like the TM for Fisher, because I already have Horn Drill, 1 at KO. I don't need another one. The only people that could learn it, though, is Kingpin, which already knows Horn Drill, so I'm not going to teach him two one-hit KO moves. That's just stupid. And also Scout, but I didn't really want him to learn anything because I liked his moveset already. And I also got 30 Ultra Balls in case I need to catch stuff. Yeah! So, I did not put on the Max Bell, like, stupid face. Oh yeah, I forgot, you can also find Zubats here. And Golbats, unfortunately, can also be found in here. But we're not going to give them a chance to show up. You know why? Because, wait for it, Max Bell. So, why can't I... Oh, that's just dumb. That's like... It's slightly different color than the regular ground. You can't walk through it, lols. Oh, wait. Oh, that's what that does. Okay. I didn't actually notice, because I actually did this part earlier, but I didn't like the intro, and I got interrupted anyway, so... It just wasn't all good all around. So, basically, you need strength here. If you don't have strength, then, well, go get strength. From where I showed you strength was in Fuchsia City. Tough luck. Gotta go find Mr. Warden's gold teeth and stuff. That's what you gotta do, and you gotta find him in Safari Zone and bring him to him in Fuchsia City, and then he'll give you the strength HM. That's just in case you didn't watch my part, which you should have if you're already here, part 69, Giggity. Yes, I will keep doing that. Because it's part 69, why not? Giggity. Yeah, I don't know why you would just be watching this part instead of the parts before it as well, but whatever. Do what you want. So anyway, this is the thing here. Now you can go through. I guess that's what that switch activated. I didn't look earlier, because that's the right way to go. But we want to go the other way, because Pokemon, there's lots of secrets and stuff. At least sometimes there are secrets. Unfortunately, I really hate this part. As you can see, two item spots. We can only get one at a time, though, so we're going to have to come back out. But first, let's look and see what we got here. We got TM43, which is Sky Attack. Ha! That's like a person I know on YouTube, only there's no E at the end of the sky, so it's not the same thing. But still, we're going to teach it to something, because, I mean, come on, it's the best flying move in the game. Like, seriously, it's like overpowered. I think it's like 120 power, probably. I think it's what it is. It may or may not be what the thing is, or something. So, we're gonna take out Fury Attack, because Fury Attack is kinda not that good. So, yeah. Sorry, Fury Attack, but... You know, live and learn sometimes. So now we got that. That's super cool. And, yeah. Now we gotta walk back. I don't think I'm really gonna need to cut this, because it's just literally just this... Although I will actually have to cut some of it, maybe, because, I mean, I have to push the strength button again, do this, but you know what, yeah, why not, who cares, I don't feel like cutting it out, because I just don't feel like, I feel like making this part of it, because I don't know how much long, I don't think that's the correct terminology, how long I will have to do this part, so I want to make sure to talk over as much as I can and make the parts with as minimal editing as possible, because... You know, it's better to do that than, like, cut it up and then just have a really short episode or part. I don't know why I still say episode, but who cares? I don't even care anymore. You know, you don't want to just, like, a really short part, like, 10 minutes long with me cutting out all that stuff. Instead, you'd probably want, like, at least maybe, like, a 15-minute part. Even though I don't cut out, like, this stuff, I just think it seems logical, because usually people like 15-minute stuff. And I don't know how when I'll be able to record again, so, you know, the more the merrier at that kind of stuff. So, now, basically, we just wasted an entire Max Repel just doing this, yeah. That's why I got some more. Not really, I just got some more because I needed it, but... Anyway, we're gonna just do this. If I mess that up, I would really cut that out. Rick Candy! Awesome. I actually didn't know that the TM was over there, or at least I didn't know that Sky Attack was in it. I didn't know you were in this game! Sky Attack LP, what are you doing in my Pokemon game? Just kidding. Anyway, Rare Candy, I went for the Rare Candy, so I didn't know it was in the other one, so I was actually kind of surprised there, I didn't know it was there. So, who do I want to give this to? Who should I give it to? Let's give it to... Let's give it to good old Mr. One of them. Actually, maybe I should I should give it to Sellout, because I don't think I'm going to be using Sellout, honestly, at all in this entire victory road. At least not a lot of it, because, after all, it's kind of to the thing, to the point where, you know, a lot of these probably ground types or rock types these trainers have. I know I screwed up that sentence, but who cares. A lot of these people probably have ground and rock types, basically what I was trying to say. And, you know, ground types not really good with electric types, so yeah. I wonder if you are good enough for me. Well, I don't know. I got all 8 badges. I got through all the robotic people asking me if I had all the badges. If I have all the badges, I'm pretty sure I'm pretty good. Just a little guess there. I don't know. So, Cool Trainer wants to fight. This is the first time we found a female Cool Trainer. I don't know if we found a male one either, but... regardless, female Cool Trainer. That's what they look like. None special. Yeah. So, they have another whip, just like the Tamer. And, funny, they have a giant cat Pokemon. That's funny. I guess it's the first time we actually saw a Persian. I say this because I do not recognize that sprite at all. This is my first time ever seeing that sprite, because, as I said, I never got this far in the original game, only in the remake Fire Red, so... seeing this sprite for the first time definitely kinda hints to me the fact that we've never seen a Persian before. So, yeah. Let's try out Sky Attack. You better be good, Ryan. You better be good. Alright, Surbird is glowing! He is such the fabulous glower. Great, now I get more money when I win. That's what Payday does this. Sky Attack, BAM! Alright, Ryan. That was pretty good. I know I can only use you 5 times, but still it's good. Anyway. Ninetales. Let's do some good old drill pecking. See how this works. Oh man, this is so surreal to do this again. I mean, it's just kinda like... it's been so long, and then just going back to it, it's kind of weird, but kind of refreshing, mostly refreshing. Just kind of like getting back into the swing of things, it's pretty nice. I lost out! What? Is that even a phrase that people say? I lost out? I never wanted to lose to anybody! Well, sorry about that, you just lost Exus right over yonder, so, your tears can go that way. I'm just gonna kick that there, just in case I want to go back for any reason. Probably didn't need to do that, because I probably won't go back. So, hey, buddy. I can see you're good. Let me see exactly how good. I'll tell you how good I am. I will tell you exactly. And they have whips, too. That's awesome. They are really good. That's why they're so good, because they whip their Pokemon and force them to be good, or else, like, no dinner for them tonight, or they whip them even more, or something like that. So, I'm really sorry about this Ivysaur, but it doesn't look like you're going to eat tonight. I'm sorry. Just, it's the way it has to be. I mean, I had to, you know, beat the game, be a Pokemon Master, so I have to ruthlessly destroy any trainer and their Pokemon that are in my way. Just how it works. And apparently I was totally wrong about everybody having, like, ground and rock types, because, they definitely do not. I don't remember much. I know I played the remake, and they're pretty much the same Pokemon. There's not that much change between the first and the second, you know, the first, this game and the remake, besides the whole, obviously there's a graphical update, but other than that, they're pretty much the same. Some levels might be different, but usually their Pokemon are the same. So yeah, it's been a while since I played this game, so yeah. But it's not like I don't know what to do, it's not that hard. It's a Pokemon game! You face 8 gym leaders. Then you go to the Elite Four, you beat them, and then you win. Like, that's how it's been since the beginning, and this is the beginning. But I've played lots of other Pokemon games, so I know what I'm getting into when I'm playing Pokemon. It's not that hard. It's not a very hard game to pick up and play, which is very good for people that don't play games a lot. If you want a nice RPG to pick up and play Pokemon. If you are a hardcore RPG guy, then you can play a more complex RPG, like, I don't know, Final Fantasy is kinda like that. Well, not too much, because I'm not a big extreme turn-based RPG guy. I usually only play Pokemon, but I played Final Fantasy, and it's not too terribly difficult to pick up and play, although I know there are some crazy specifics with, like, different classes, and, like, all the weapon classes, and levels up, and jobs, and which are basically the same thing as classes, but in Final Fantasy 1, you just pick your job right away, but whatever. And there's some crazy items that can do crazy things that I don't really pay attention to a lot of them. I'm not a really complex guy, so, you know, I don't bother with a lot of the crazy stuff. like that. So yeah, Pokemon, good pick-up and play RPG. Also, I guess if you're a more hardcore RPG, I guess you can play the Persona series. I've never played that, but I've seen YouTube videos of that, and wow, that is confusing. I was like, there are these, you have this attack where you can do this, and then also you can use your Persona, which is your alternate self, which is basically just an extra attack, and you can attack in different ways, and each person has, like, certain different ways you can level up your Persona, and you can fuse them together with other ones, and you can fuse them with certain things that give it certain attack boosts and stat boosts that go this way and that way. You can get that up if you fuse it with this one. And then you can deal with demons to get cool spell cards, which you can use to fuse with demon with your personas to get them better stuff. And it's just like, whoa, okay, back up there, I'm good. And aside from that, the game didn't look too interesting anyway. It just looked like your standard RPG, except it was more confusing. But yeah, I had a chance. You had a chance and you blew it. I think it's there's a song quote in there somewhere, but I'm just not seeing it. I concede, you're better than me. That's right, I'm better than you. What is this? I don't know what the special floor is all about. Obviously, we can't go that way because we need to do switch puzzles, because switch puzzles are the most fun thing. Yeah, this requires strength to move, but unlike the later games where you could just keep pressing A at the rock until it asks you if you want to use strength, you have to go into your Pokemon menu and then use strength manually, and it's dumb. It's just really dumb. So, yeah. This is Giggity Road. I mean, Victory Road. It's pretty fun. We are going all over the place, pushing these rocks into their holes. Giggity. Oh, that's all you need? Just one? What's over here? I'm curious what's over here. Can't go that way, because that'll just block everything off. Sucks. Alright, well, we'll face this guy, and then I guess we'll call it a part. Because it's already 17 minutes. Giggity Road is the final test for trainers! Giggity. Oh man, I'll show you that Giggity Road final test. Alright, we got Machoke. He's gonna choke us with his fists, and he's got an eye missing, so that's not good. So that means he'll probably miss, and he'll, like, crush our leg, so we'll still live, but we'll feel extreme pain, which is even better. It's even better than just dying, isn't it? Just being alive and feeling extreme pain is so much greater. When they're gonna kill you eventually, it's just so good to have you be finished off slowly. Would you rather be finished off slowly than quickly? I mean, you just feel all the pain going to your body, coursing through your nervous system. It's great. Much better than just being killed instantly, right? I mean, that's just too cliche and boring. Not for Pokemans, you gotta just get killed really slowly and painfully. That's what the health bar is for, because it's just like, it just slowly goes down as they feel pain. It's really good. It's a really good message. It implies so heavily that we want to be killed slowly and painfully. So good. Very, very good message, Pokemon. Love your messages. Even though you leave a little bit too much on my phone, really, Pokemon, you gotta stop that. I don't want your messages when you're drunk at 2 in the morning asking me if you could pick me up in the bar because you had a little too much tequila, okay? Buddy, I'm not your cab taxi driver guy, alright? I'm not gonna just pick you up everywhere. I have a life, I need to sleep, so I'm sorry, but... And stop sending me those crazy pictures of yourself naked, either when you're drunk. That's just gross. I don't like that. See, I'm sorry. I think you overheard me talking. Whoops, I almost dropped my controller. If you get stuck, try moving some boulders around. Giggity. There was probably some sort of Giggity reference in there. Oh yeah, if you want to know what that is. That is Moltres, one of the legendary birds. I didn't show off Zapdos and Articuno yet. Articuno can be found in the Seafoam Islands, which we were, you know, surfing to on either side. We cleared out the trainers not too long ago, after we fought Blaine. And Zapdos can be found on the power plant, which is if you just go right from Cerulean, and, you know, like, before you get to that place with that Pokemon Center before Rock Tunnel, if you just go surf to the right, there's, like, a body of water instead, and you go down and just follow the path, you'll take it to the power plant. You find Zapdos. I was gonna do them after the main game, because they're not really, you know, they're also not only extremely powerful, I think they're, well, actually I think they might be like level 50, so it might, and I didn't feel like going to them. Maybe I will before I battle the Elite Four, who knows, but if I find a way to get to Moltres, maybe I will battle him. In Fire Red and Leaf Green, Moltres is not there anymore. Moltres is instead in the, I don't know what it's in, I think it's one of the three Sevii Island caves, I think it's like the first one. It's one of the first three, definitely. I think it's the first one. It's like some fire, Mount Blaze, or Mount... don't know, but it's there. And TMO5.
What's TMO5? Find out the next part. Ooh, mystery.
So, until next part. See ya.